to hear and you can't hear that one. Fred can help you. Fred, hold your hand. See Fred. He looks like Einstein. So in lieu of our passing the keys, you're going to receive your roles because this is an interactive pageant that we'll be doing today. You all have a part in the story. You can stay right where you are. Unless you already have an assigned part that you know what it is. But you're going to have a voice in the story at some point. So we'll hand out a line. And we're going to hold up a cue card for you so you'll know exactly where you need to say what you're going to say. Now, is there anybody that wants to be in the pageant up front who doesn't have a part? So raise your hand if you're growing up and you want to be in the pageant.
Go for it.
You have roles. Alright, so before we begin the service, are there any announcements for the life of the church or the community that we need to share today? Linda?
I just want to remind everybody this is the last time to sell baskets and Zimbabwe and have a card. We have three left. They're really cool. So see now.
Good morning, everyone. I want to thank you one last time for supporting the Church Ed's Angel and Elf spot. We sponsor two children. So thank you so much for everybody's generosity and getting all the gifts back on time. And they were dropped off last week. So thank you so much.
All right, and so let's...
All the girls, they were...
All right, if you want to have holy silence, we all have to have holy silence. But that's a really select choice, so try not to make it. So why don't we say hello to each other for a couple minutes while I pass out your holes. So stand up, pass the keys, I lied.
Thank you.
is your non-card? There's one, two, page 135 of the record. Stand up, please.
The song of hope, offered by Mary when she said yes, and sang out a vision of holy justice and loving mercy for all people in the world.
The vision of hope has come to us.
Then we listened to song and silence as Elizabeth and Zachariah cultivated patience, strength, and insight in their lifelong journey toward peace and love's living presence. This morning's songs of joy help retell the story of the Holy Family and the Messiah's arrival in the world.
Treatment, hope those who are living in remission and hoping for stability and long-term remission, and for those who have passed beyond due to cancer or other life-limiting conditions. Yeah. maybe recovering from falls or lack of balance or changes in stability, because that can come from any number of causes, including icy ground. Yes, Jim.
Well, my best friend Stuart, that I took to dinner, to Brigham and Women's last year, they have a tube inserted in his, last week, they had a tube inserted in his back to drain his kidney, because he has cancer pressing up against the tube. And just prayers and wishes for his recovery. Thank you.
For Stuart's journey, for the treatments that he is undergoing, also having to do with cancer, and for those that are creative in the ways that they help invent and care for him and for his body and for so many of our bodies, that we may go on to have sustainable lives, and for all that may count for him. Father prayer. We always try to do prayers in celebration as well. For instance, the bird count that was supposed to happen yesterday got rescheduled to today, and now Lori Casey's skeptical that it's going to work today because the wind is so fierce, and the birds that even were at the bird feeders yesterday aren't showing up at the bird feeders, but don't you know, I saw seven ravens in the middle of the road having a feast. So some of the birds are still on wing and find a way to show up for the bird count. Very good. So today is bird count, so feel free to count birds and report it to the Mountain Conservation Center. So gratitude for the birds and the winds and the bright day. Other prayers of celebration. Then let us enter into this time of prayer. Holy God, today is the day that we call upon joy. We have prayed the prayers of hope and of peace. And today we reflect on what joy means in our lives. How is this something that we cannot control and come by, that it surprises us and springs out from a deep place that we find it hard to tap into sometimes. And yet we are told and we are reminded that it is something that we can cultivate, that it is there for us to touch and turn to again and again. That we know from the time of journey, of pregnancy, even the time of Advent, that there are times in our lives when we are tuned into joy and we can find it within reach. Teach us what it means to reach for joy and be able to have it reach back to us and connect with us even in the darkest and yet the most holy of times. We are your children and we are fashioned for joy. Help us find it. We offer you now our silence. And we offer you those words that you first taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. The rest of the service is all a big storytelling, and you know by now that you all have a part because you got some lines, didn't you? So I have a cue cards up here, and when I hold up the cue card, depending on who you are, you're going to read the lines that you were given. And there's going to be people all over the congregation reading those lines, and there may be some people up front helping you say the lines as well. This is a reminder that in any story, including the holy story, which has been told for 2,000 years and is connected to more ancient texts that were drawn upon at the time that the story was unfolding. People were using their voices to sing and to shout and to tell each other what was important. We are important. Our voices are important. And the story doesn't end 2,000 years ago. And the story doesn't end 30 years after the changing of the millennia. The story is still being told now. The story is in our hands and feet. It is in our minds and our hearts. It is in our voices and the choices and the way we live our lives. The children may be acting out and the youth may be telling much of the story, but we ask you to be part of it as a reminder that you are part of it. This is not something that is told for your entertainment, that you passively receive. You live this story. If this story exists, if love walks in the world, it walks in you. You are the story. Enjoy being part of the story this morning. So my marriage, come forward.
Jewish people who lived far from home, in exile, feeling abandoned and isolated. He told them, "The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shone. For a child has been born for us, a baby given to us."
Isaiah also told his people, "Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he will be named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority will grow continually, and there shall be endless peace, and of God's kingdom of love and justice there will be no end." Hundreds of years later, people remember the prophet Isaiah's words and interpreted them in a different way when a new baby named Jesus was born.
So I hope you all have your hymnals. We're going to sing carols between each act of this pageant. So please, let's start with "Come All Ye Faithful," verses 1 and 2.
Thank you.
in the Gospel of Luke, we learn about a young woman named Mary engaged to a man named Joseph. And the angel Gabriel, who is sent by God to visit Mary.
The angel Gabriel said to Mary, "Good morning, you are beautiful with God's beauty, beautiful inside and out. God be with you." And when Mary was puzzled by the angel's message, Gabriel said, "Mary, you have nothing to fear. God has a surprise for you. You'll give birth to a son and call him Jesus."
Mary was puzzled and asked the angel, "How can this be?"
The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will be with one, the power of the highest hover over you. Your child will be called the Holy Son of God. And did you know that your cousin Elizabeth, whom everyone called barren, is 6 months pregnant? You see, nothing is impossible with God."
And Mary sang out, "Yes, I see it all now. I am ready to serve. Let it be with me, just as you say."
After the angel Gabriel left, Mary also went to visit her cousin, Elizabeth, whose baby would grow up to be John the Baptist. In the home of Zechariah and Elizabeth, Mary and her cousin sang songs of hope and justice, trusting that God's love could change the world through their children. These two women believed themselves to be blessed, 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 3 times blessed.
We are now going to play Amazing Grace for you, so please feel free to sing along.
Joseph went from the town of Nazareth to Bethlehem. his ancestor David's town to register for the census. He brought Mary, who was pregnant, with him. Together with their faithful donkey, Mary and Joseph made their way to Bethlehem.
While they were there, the time came for her to give birth. She gave birth to a son, her firstborn. She wrapped him in a blanket and laid him in a manger, because there was no room in the inn. And so it was that Jesus was born into our world and surrounded by faithful beasts of all sorts.
Suddenly, God's angels stood. stood among them, and God's glory blazed around them. They were terrified.
The angel said, "Don't be afraid. I am here to announce a great and joyful event that is meant for everyone, worldwide. A Savior has just been born, a Savior who is Messiah. This is what you are to look for, a baby wrapped in a blanket and lying in a manger." And at once the angel was joined by a huge angelic choir singing God's praises.
Glory to God in the heavenly heights. Peace to all people on earth.
Glory to God in the heavenly heights. Peace to all people on earth.
And then we can have a special music. When word of their inquiry got to Herod, he was terrified, and not Herod alone, but most of Jerusalem as well. Herod lost no time. He gathered all high priests and religious experts in the city together and asked them for more information.
Then he arranged a secret meeting with the scholars from the East, pretending to be as devout as they were. He got them to tell him exactly what the birth announcement star appeared. Then he told them the prophecy about that one. Go find this child, leave no stone unturned. As soon as you find him, send word, and I'll join you at once in your worship.
Instructed by the king, they set off. Then the star appeared again, the same star they had seen in the eastern skies. It led them on until it hovered over the place of the child. They could hardly contain themselves. They were in the right place. They had arrived at the right time. The wise ones entered the house and saw the child in the arms of Mary, his mother. Overcome, they kneeled and worshipped baby Jesus. Then they opened their luggage and presented gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
In a dream, the wise ones were warned not to report back to Herod, so they worked out another route, left the territory without being seen, and returned to their own country. Herod was tricked.
After the scholars were gone, God's angel showed up again in Joseph's dream and commanded, "Get up, take the child and his mother, and flee to Egypt. Stay until further notice. Herod is in the hunt for his child and wants to kill him." Joseph obeyed. He got up, took the child and his mother under the cover of darkness.
Herod, when he realized that the scholars had tricked him, flew into a rage.
The family, refugees in Egypt, returned from their exile after King Herod's reign ended and it was safe to come home. We now have more special music from the Roberts family.
Helping those who need some support. Be
that you will bless the retelling of this story, the joy with which we receive the story as told by our children and our youth, that we will see ourselves in this story and go on telling it in one form or another, and that you will bless these offerings of our time and our songs and our voices and our resources, and let them go to work in the world to bring those gifts of Advent, hope, peace, joy, and love, alive into the world. Thanks be to God.
Into a world living in darkness comes light in the form of a child. Into our lives that are messy and miraculous comes love.
The people we met in the Gospels dared to believe that God might do something new, something different. They told the story.
They were the first ones to tell each other and us how hope, peace, joy, love, and justice came to live among us, and how love promises to keep coming back.
This morning, as we retell the story of Jesus' birth, we recognize that we have parts in this story too, because it is still unfolding, still being told.
Love lives in us.
Light lives in us.
The story lives in us.
Thank you.
the teacher benediction, and then we'll head out.